We've posted several videos about chargers and power banks from Anker GaN Prime series. And today we got our hands on a 3-port 65W GaN charger from GaN Prime series. It adopts industry's first all-GaN technology to improve performance massively. So let's see how we can achieve this. The package continues GaN Prime series design and some specs info are printed on the side. Tear off the sealing strip and open the box. Just like the 140W and 120W. It also comes with some documents and a rubber pad which can fix the charger on the wall outlet more tightly, and it won't fall off even if we shake it. The Anker and GaN Prime are printed on the black matte surface, and two USB-C and USB-A ports are on this silver panel. And then let's take a look at the specs info. Model is A2668. It can support input of 120V, 50 or 60Hz, 1.8A, and the output can be up to 65W. It also has passed different certifications. You can pause to take a look. The size of the charger is about 66x29x38mm, so the power density is about 0.88W³/cm. Compared with Apple's 61W charger, the size is almost half of it. And the weight is about 123 grams. ChargeLab Power ZKM002C shows the USB-C one supports FCB, SCB, AFC, QC3.0+, QC4+, PD3.0, PBS, Apple 2.4A, and Samsung 5V 2A protocols. And it also supports 4 fixed videos of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 15V, 3A, and 20V, 3.25A, and a set of PBS. Switch to the USB-C 2, the protocols and video info of those two boards are exactly the same, so you can choose any USB-C board to get the maximum power. As for the USB-A port, it supports FCB, SCB, AFC, and QC3+ protocols. Next, let's go ahead and take it apart to see how did the Anker achieve all GaN technology. As always, use the spudger to pry along the gap. You can find lots of pink silicon adhesives inside, which is good for consumers but not for the teardown. So we have to use the cutting machine to cut it off. After taking out the PCB module, we found the entire module is covered with pink silicon adhesives, just like other Anker chargers. Some white plastic tapes are pasted inside the shell. Clean off all silicon adhesives. The black and white wires are connected to the input PCB. All plug-in components are on the front. And the transformer is in the middle. Again, I see optocoupler and SMD Y capacitor are soldered on the back. ChargeLab found it adopts a QR flyback topology, and the secondary synchronous rectifier also adopts GaN technology. The input fuse is from Better Electronics for input over current protection, 5A, 250V, and the common mode choke is wound with magnet and insulated wires. The safety X2 capacitor is from DGCX, 0.50 microfarad. This SMD bridge rectifier can convert AC into pulsed DC. Those 5 filter capacitors are from Yongming, 22 microfarad, 400 volts, 110 microfarad in total. And the I-shaped differential mode choke is insulated with a heat shrinkable tube. The mass controller is actually like an IC from SouthChip and adopts QFN 6x8 package. It can save more space with built-in driver. Here is the transformer tightly wrapped with tape. And these two SMD Y capacitors are from Holy Stone. They're connected in series to improve with standard voltage. The optocoupler is used for output voltage feedback. And a blue Y capacitor is soldered to the edge of the PCB. Remove most of the components on the front, so we can take a closer look at the synchronous rectification controller. It can drive the GaN synchronous rectifier directly and comes from SouthChip. It also supports turn-on detection and fast turn-off. The synchronous rectifier is from InnoScience, which is a GaN power transistor, 150 volts, 7 milliohm. Those two solid capacitors for output filtering are from Yongming MPT series, 470 microfarad, 25 volts. The 32-bit MCU with built-in M0 core is from iSoft and adopts QFN32 package. It features high performance, low power, and can be used for internal temperature detection and protection. Here is the small PCB for USB-C 1 port, the buck inductor, filter capacitor, and some MOSFETs are on the front, while the protocol chip, MOSFETs, and current sense amplifier are on the back. The protocol chip is from iSmartware, which integrates a 7-amp synchronous buck converter. The buck MOSFET is from AOS and adopts DFN 3x3 package, 40 volts, 5 milliohm. And the current sense amplifier is from SG Micro, used for output current sampling. Another same AOS buck MOSFET is on the front. This is a 4.7 microhenry alloy buck inductor. The solid capacitor for output filtering is from Yongming and is insulated with heat-resistant tape. The output VBUS MOSFET is also from AOS. The plastic sheet inside the USB-C connector is anchor blue. Moving to another PCB of USB-C 2, the filter capacitor, buck inductor, and some resistances are on the front. The protocol chip, USB-C connector, and VBUS MOSFET are on the back. The protocol chip from iSmartware is the same as the USB-C 1, but this one is for USB-C 2 and USB-A output. Those two buck MOSFETs are also from AOS. Another 4.7 microhenry alloy buck inductor is here. The solid capacitor is also from Yongming, 470 microfarad, 25 volts. Those two current sense amplifiers are also from SG Micro, same as the USB-C 1. This VBUS MOSFET is also from AOS, used for USB-C 2. Finally, here is the USB-A connector, which is also in anchor blue. No components on the back. Well, that's all components of this Anker 3-port 65W GaN charger. After taking it apart, we found the internal components are filled with silicon adhesives, making the charger more durable. And except for the GaN IC on the primary side, it also integrates GaN synchronous rectifier to achieve an all-GaN design. Okay, that's all for today's video. Feel free to click the corners to check the teardown of other GaN Prime products. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you in the next video. Bye!